بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا الكريم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته and welcome to Takaful online course. And today's session is the continuation of the discussions on the main differences between insurance and Takaful. And we have covered in the last previous sessions the Sharia ruling on insurance and Takaful. And today we carry on some of the remaining differences, and we start with the number two, which is the Sharia. Talking about the Sharia meaning here, talking about a position of Sharia in the business model of insurance. Of course, no one argued that Sharia has no space in the conventional insurance. It is not part of their governance structure. So meaning that it goes to the management decision, it goes back to what's called the board of directors to set the directions and the products and services offered. Whereby Sharia in the Takaful is basically a core business. It's also a core business in the Islamic banking. The Sharia is the main driver for the business model of the Takaful. Sharia has impacted the business model where it has been restructured from buying and selling to a donation. That's number one, and it is also part and parcel of the overall business operations of the Takaful operators. Sharia basically has a say when it comes to the permissibility of the product or otherwise, and it is reflected in what's so called the Sharia governance within the structure of the Islamic financial institutions such as the Takaful operator, whereby we have the board of directors and we have the managements, and we have also the Sharia board or the Sharia committee or the Sharia advisory council, who basically has a responsibility to ensure that whatever products and services offered by the Islamic financial institution is the Sharia compliance. So it is reflected in this committee, which is normally a kind of collective Sharia scholars. In Malaysia, for example, the number is 5 members. According to the IOFI Sharia governance standards, is 3. So being 3 or 5 depends on the jurisdictions. So these a group of Sharia scholars will basically have the responsibility to make sure that the products, services, legal documentation, terms and conditions, the structures, and the policies and the legal documentations and whatever has been used in the telemarketing information in the website, the agreements, and so on and so forth, that basically related to the Takaful operators of the Islamic financial institutions, related to their products and offerings, are basically Sharia compliance. And this Sharia board have the responsibility to ensure that kind of compliance. And it is one of the lines of defense. And also we have the Sharia departments, which is part of the governance structures. And we have the Sharia, what's so called a review. We have the Sharia compliance as well. It is part of the structure. We have also the Sharia audit. So as you can see, the Sharia is embedded. It is a structure within the Islamic financial institutions, especially the Takaful operators. And it is reflected through different corporate governance organs, as I mentioned, like the in-house what's so called Sharia, which is the Sharia department, some related, as I mentioned, the review, for example, the research, and the Sharia compliance, which is the under the compliance department, and the audit or the Sharia audit under the audit, and we have what's so called the Sharia board, which is an external or an independent group of Sharia scholars that basically provide advice and consultancy and guidance to the Islamic financial institution in order to ensure that products and services are Sharia compliance. Meaning that Sharia business model of Takaful has been validated, number one, but over and above that, when the financial institution engaged to some new offering in products based on investments or protections or savings, or basically a kind of relationship with the Re-Takaful companies, operators, or reinsurance companies. So basically the involvements of the Sharia board and other basically departments will be involved to make sure all the a process, all the business operations is in Sharia. Sharia in Takaful, it preserve prior and post. Prior approval, whereby the Sharia board, they have the responsibility before the product is approved, before the product is going to the central bank, before the product is going to the market, they have to make sure it is Sharia compliance. And after the product is offered, so the Sharia compliance, through the Sharia review, will come and vet through and review and examine what has been offered to make sure that they are in line with the Sharia rules and regulations and in line with the Sharia board resolutions. And after that, there's the Sharia audit will come on board as another line of defense to also vet through and do perform examinations and review to make sure that the Sharia rules and principles are preserved, honored, respected, and preserved, and business is in compliance with Sharia. And this is a true a periodical review, through a regular and planned exercise, which is normally coordinated between various parties within the Islamic financial institutions. So as you can see here, Sharia is strongly integrated in the business model of the Takaful. And basically, that's how it make business Sharia compliance. And every year, through the annual report, the Sharia board will provide a kind of Sharia compliance endorsement to make sure that the business of the Takaful operator is in Sharia compliance. And of course, throughout the course, you may have some kind of issues, you may have some kind of challenges, you may have some kind of mistakes, you may have some of some potential Sharia non-compliance through the course of offering your business in Takaful. That's where the coordinators will take place between the Islamic financial institution through the various departments like the Sharia compliance, like the Sharia audit, like the Sharia department, other business unit, and the Sharia board to address those potential issues, those potential Sharia non-compliance issue, in order to address them and determine their status, whether they are Sharia compliance or otherwise, and if it is so, what's the course of corrections and measurements to rectify those mistakes, because sometimes it is part of the operation operational risk, and because of due to the size of the Islamic financial institutions, complex operations, huge market, integrated in technologies and other what's so called partners and third party. So in that course, something may go wrong, mistakes may happen, and that's where the Islamic financial institutions, in a coordination and collaboration with the Sharia board, would address those issues, try to fix them, address them, and keep the course of Sharia compliance ongoing throughout the course of the business operation of the Takaful operator. So this is the point of Sharia that shows its importance, whereby it has no space in the insurance business, but it is strongly present in the Takaful operator. With this, thank you very much, and see you inshallah in the coming sessions. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.